Tagovailoa. Everybody's been on the same page with Tua. And that last drive was a perfect example.
You today, 3 touchdowns, Tyreek Hill, 466 yards for you today. Unbelievable day. Yeah, and Tyreek Hill with 2 touchdowns. What was working so well through the air for you guys today?
Well, we just stuck to our game plan. You know, for me, it was just going through my progression, working through my progression, not trying to make things up out there. And we stuck to that, so it was working for us.
So you see what Tua and Tyreek were able to do. On that last play, you know, that's something that we've been working on this offseason and even into training camp and all that stuff. So.
Excuse me, what you had mentioned about Tua, I'm just curious, today he was named the AFC Offensive Player of the Week.
Which I don't find offensive. Seeing if you guys are awake.
And Tua, how good is this guy? He is really good, and he has stepped his game up in a way that I don't think a lot of people saw coming.
You guys are 2-0. You've won those 2 games on the road, and you head home. What does that say about this team, of where you are right now in the season?
Yeah, I think it's still early to say what we are as a team. We're still trying to find our identity offensively, defensively, and collectively. So we'll continue to watch the film. We'll look at that, and we'll continue to build off of it.
And that play fake, and right here, too, a pump fake, and then fires that ball so early, Jim. When you can throw the ball on time and rhythm and that early, I mean, Tua's getting the ball out faster than any quarterback in the National Football League right now, and that allows these guys to have run after the catch. His timing, impeccable.
Yeah, thank you. Tony Romo knows it, man, you know?
Of course.
Big, fastest and most accurate quarterback in the NFL, of course, is Tua Tagovailoa. Welcome to another Dolphins and Tua Tagovailoa content. I'm Ukulelevis with my good buddy, the big European Tagovailoa supporter, or Big Euro, as we call him, or sometimes Big Bats. But anyway, right. If you're here for the first time, make sure you subscribe, press the like button, and make sure you share content. Back to you, Ukulelevis. Oh, yes. Thank you. Welcome back. So we are both teams are coming from a loss. That means... Both will be looking for a win this week, so obviously one of them will win.
Oh, of course, you know. Look, Miami Dolphins are favored by 11 points.
11 points on October 8th, so the game is at 1 p.m. Eastern time. You know, interesting is that these teams actually kind of know each other. I mean, you know.
That is true.
Dable was supposed to be, I mean, he is a former Tua Tagovailoa offensive coordinator back in Alabama.
Yep.
So he kind of knows him. Here he is. There's a picture of him with, I think on the left is Jalen Hurts, and on the right is Mac Jones.
Mac Jones, yeah.
This were back in the days. I mean, look. Just before he got the New York Giants game, he was the offensive coordinator for the Buffalo Bills. So they kind of know each other. I mean, that was from 2018 to 2021. So there's a lot of familiarities between these two teams. So. Yeah.
And plus, he was coach there in New England.
Yeah, he's actually former offensive coordinator for Miami Dolphins.
That's right. So, you know, they know each other.
Yeah, so both losses for the New York Giants and the Miami Dolphins were both ugly this past weekend. We'll see which one comes up. So we'll take a look at some of the stats that happened, on their last games. We'll look at the defense because we never looked at our defense last time and their defense. Okay. Yeah. So because it's going to, I think that's what's going to win the games for both teams.
And then, let's talk about what you got planned.
Yeah, well, what I have planned is just to show you a little bit of the New York defense, because Mike McDaniel, during his press conference, was talking about how huge they were. And he's actually right, you know, and they're really good. And so that's what we're going to watch out. And then we're going to see if Tua Tagovailoa and Tyreek Hill, Jalen Waddle, and now, you know, Devon Achan will be able to score on them or not. So that's what we'll do on this. And we'll show you everything.
Okay. Well, here I put up stats for defense for New York.
Yeah. Thanks, man. Because really, I mean, when Mike McDaniel mentioned that they're big guys out there, I believe him, because And yeah. I also saw the offense, the New York Giants offensive line. They're huge guys, like 6'7". There's a few of them. Yeah. But look here, like Kayvon Thibodeau, he's like 6'5". And Leonard Williams, 6'5". Thibodeau, man, look at that.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
You know, total 2 sacks, 2 tackle for losses, 1 patted down. I mean, the guy.
Monster.
2 quarterback hits. Really, man. He was busy last week. So, you know, it'll be tough, you know.
Yeah, look, another quarterback hit from Dexter Lawrence, the second. He's 6'4".
That is another huge guy.
Big guys.
You know, yeah. Isaiah Simmons there, 6'4", man, linebacker. I mean, didn't he just, like, come from Arizona?
Wasn't he
controversial this week also? Oh yeah, the hip drop tackle that Pete Carroll called out. He wants it out of football. So, you know, I don't blame Pete Carroll there, because I guess he went after. In this picture, you can see it. Geno Smith. You know,
that's true. That's true.
So at the end, Geno Smith said he was a dirty player. So.
Yeah.
Oh man, it's just don't hurt people. That's what we say.
Well, you know, I mean, personally, I think it's illegal. They should put it out, take it out of football.
Maybe
next year they'll take it out. Yeah, but look, here is as you can see, the Seahawks was rushing. Yeah. They rushed for 121 yards on New York,
yeah,
on the Giants, and then, you know, the receivers were eating. They had 173 yards, so.
Yeah.
So maybe it'll be good for if you're looking at that way for our offense.
Yeah.
And look, I put up our defense here. So for this week, as you can see, we have David Long Jr. had the most tackles. You know, 7 solos.
Yeah, that is right. Yeah.
2 tackles for a loss, and Javon Holland was second.
Yeah.
You know, with 6 solo. And 4 solo tackles, 6 total. But, you know, the numbers here are a little bit different because they're not always different teams,
every
I guess.
Week different. Yeah.
But but Van Ginkel, man.
Van Ginkel, man.
He was, you know, he had 2 solo tackles, 2 sacks, 3 tackles for loss, you know.
Yeah.
And he had 2 quarterback hits, you know, a total of 3 hits, and he had 2 of them. So, we gave him double A's, man. Double flowers. We gave Van Ginkel double flowers on that one. But that was the defense last week.
So tough loss. There it is.
Van Ginkel, at least we see something good.
We're
going to move on to our offense.
Okay. Yeah, let me put it up here.
Week 4, we put this out before the Monday night football game. So, you know, basically it's all the same, but... nothing really changed. The only thing we did differently was we looked here and tried to come up with our triple X stats. So this is what we have.
Okay, so I put it up. Best NFL quarterback receiver duo.
This is it. So now, Tyreek Hill and Jalen Waddle were the best last year. With Tua, the 3 of them. So that's why we call them triple threat.
Mm-hmm.
So this year, they're third. And so Waddle was out in week 3, and now he's back in week 4.
That's right.
So as you can see, the point stuff here is the number 1 is basically the LA Rams, and the number 2 is is Kirk Cousins with Justin Jefferson and Jordan Addison. And number 3, of course, now is Tyreek Hill and Jalen Waddle. So we'll see if they're able to put any
of course
any yards or receive what kind of game they're going to have against the Giants.
All right,
so let me put up the rest of stats here.
So what we got here is
triple threats is always between the quarterback and the 2 rushers or the 2 receivers. So in this case you have here the 2 receivers, which is basically Tyreek Hill and Jalen Waddle. And then on the 2 rushers, you have Raheem Mostert and Devon Achane. The problem is any of these 2 triple threats can receive the ball also. So if Raheem Mostert and Devon Achane, they got 549 yards of total rushing. But look at their receiving. you know, Raheem Mostert received already caught 115 yards, and for Achan is like 53 yards
for 168.
You know, pick your poison. Which one is it?
Absolutely. Right.
All of them can catch the ball, and that's and that's the threat that we are talking about. Yeah. And all of them can run the ball from
that
the back.
The right.
So, and that's what we're talking about, the threat. So, I didn't list any of the runs that that Jalen Waddle or Tyreek Hill has, but I just listed for this week, we just listed the receiving yards and for both running backs. Very dangerous, very dangerous. So here is a time for you.
Yeah, that's right.
So the time for week four, putting all the times together from week one through week five, and the top five time miles per hour fastest that players in the NFL all come from the Miami Dolphins.
Absolutely.
Of course, Jalen Waddle hasn't been well, so but we got him at number 13 there in the total speed from
that is right.
all the way to now. Okay.
So
the first five is basically Devon Achane.
Fast.
With 21.93
miles. Wow.
And during week three and week two, on first week was Tyreek Hill, who is number two on this one with 21.66.
Amazing.
And Raheem Mostert is number three on from week two, 21.62.
31
and,
years old.
Tyreek Hill, week number four, with 21.52.
Wow.
And again, our fifth fastest time in the NFL this year so far from week three is Devon Achane. Like I said again, Jalen Waddle is in there with 20.99 miles per hour. So these guys are really fast, and that's what makes the triple threat even more, you know, because of their speed. And as you can see, they're really, really fast. And you know, over here with the Giants, we saw that they've listed Saquon Barkley as back. So that's what they got listed here because he didn't play last week.
No.
But they said that maybe it could change, but it looks like he is playing. So that will be something for the defense to look at.
It's a possibility he's playing, and that'll be a tough game for the Miami
very possible. Defense. So I guess we'll come to the end of it. So what we'll do is give you, you know, last week I said they were going to win by 41 to 21 by 20. And it was us who had the 20, and they had 48.
So
missed that this
one
week.
You want to make again? What you're going to, who you, I mean, Dolphins are supposed to win by 11.
Yeah, okay, man. I mean, look, I'll go with the average score that the Dolphins have had. They've had like 37.
Okay.
After four games, they've scored 37 points as average.
Right.
So I'll go with 37 points to, let me see, to 21.
Okay.
He will, all right, Daniel Jones will score. And,
if Saquon Barkley is back,
will be a very good game.
Yeah.
Anyway.
That's it for today.
Yeah, that's right. And so we'll see you next time. And take it easy, everybody. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you.
Make sure if you're still here, make sure you press the like button or subscribe if you haven't.
Share
we'll content. See you next time.
Yeah.
Take care.
Oh yeah, 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 oh yeah.